Hey everyone, and welcome to Wintergatan Wednesdays. I have been really busy this week assembling the Marble Machine X, and I've been working on a lot of different sections of the machine, so I will cover several different parts in this video. I started with this spring tension system that goes on the very, very top of the Marble Machine X and controls the registrators. And the registrator has to spring back into their original position. And with this rod and these 38 pieces that I'm making right now, you can adjust the spring tension. So I'm grinding a little flat spot, and then I'm drilling a small little hole for the spring to go into this M5 threaded rod. You can see them there. It's nice because I'm actually sanding the pieces now. I got a lot of slack from the technicians at the Spielkraft Museum when they saw the first marble machine, and they saw that I didn't sand the plywood pieces. I was like, oh, I think it's okay. But then they said that if you actually sand the plywood to a sheen like this, it almost acts as a lacquer. It gives a protective surface for the plywood. So it's not only aesthetical, it's actually a little bit functional as well. So the spring tension rod has M8 threaded inserts in the side and will be part of the whole frame structure, where we can really attach it really rigidly to the side of the frame with those M8 inserts later. So we don't have the springs yet for this rod, but we ordered them and they're on their way to me. Wait, I think this blade is mounted backwards. Of all the stupid things I've done on this channel, I put this new blade in and I was like, this new blade doesn't cut well. And I'm like, oh, this bandsaw sucks. So here I'm sawing two temporary shafts that will be replaced by square tubing later. It's for the muting system that rides on these two shafts. And this round 15 millimeter shaft that I'm working on here is a pivot shaft that sits at the very base of the Marble Machine X and has a lot of levers pivoting on it. So the levers for the brake of the flywheel and the levers of the clutch of the flywheel, and also the levers for the mechanical rhythm machine pivots on this shaft. And I had to tap some M8 threads in the side of it. And in order to know where to drill the holes for these shafts and for the flywheel attachment system, I made this template on the CNC machine, because it's always better to use the CNC machine for measuring when you can. And you can see the finish here, that the holes are really nicely placed, so that's good. I got a new 16 millimeter drill to drill the clearance hole for this back pivot shaft. And to be able to drill those holes, I had to remove the big marble lifting ring gear one. So here you can see that I'm attaching the template also on the other side, so that hole location is very precise. And I'm measuring here how long I need the pivot shaft to be, making a little mark and cutting it off to length. I don't have a metal lathe, so I challenged myself with tapping the M8 thread on this side to see how precise and how exact I can do it with hand tools. And it's not completely concentric or completely vertical, but this shaft is not spinning around. This has no rotation. It's just supposed to be stuck and still, and I think in the end I got it really nice. Actually, it really works. It's a real freedom for me to finally be able to work a little bit with metal, because metal is a complete new area for me. I'm a plywood person, and metal is another world. I've been getting metal shreds in my fingers the whole week. In CAD this should be 784, and it's on my eye, it's exactly 784. Here I'm starting on the flywheel attachment system. And this is a piece of big square tubing that I have to weld onto the frame. And it was quite rusty, so I cleaned it up with a wire brush a little bit. And then I could use the same hole template again to locate where all the holes goes. So you can see there that it is a kind of a digital finish of the whole placement. You can see that I didn't use a ruler for the measurements. The flywheel is going to be adjustable for belt tensioning, so you can see how the M8 bolt can ride in the slots to enable the belt tension.
So this is also typical when building, because I'm done with this piece. I have the slots cut on both ends, but to be able to weld it onto the machine, I need a coupling from this to this, the argon gauze for the TIG welder.
Il continue avec Everock, Vanessa Zagui Carlier et ce bon vivant, cet insatiable bambocheur.
Bonjour monsieur, je voudrais une petite connexion pour connecter le avec le. C'est ça. Bonjour monsieur, je voudrais une petite connexion pour connecter le avec le. And it's closed at lunchtime. No. And I'm practicing my phrase perfectly. I'm so stupid. 15 past 12. Opening at 2 o'clock. So this is why it takes so long time to get stuff done. Things like this, you know? I went to 3 stores, and in the end, I think we have cobbled something together. This regulator fits this bottle. This Swedish regulator I can't use. But this hose didn't fit anything that goes into the TIG. So one guy came running after me with an ID, and he gave it to me for free. He just said, now you go. So the guys at the store became so tired of me, so in the end they gave it to me for free. Does this fit now? Of course not. So one day spent. So maybe I can connect this in another way. Argon is a noble gas, so you don't have to be too worried about this. It's not explosive or flammable or anything like that. Okay. I'm taking it really slowly, and I'm trying to be as respectful as I can to that this is a new area for me. Let's test my first test. I have a puddle. Yay! I melted some metal. I'm on 60 amps. I think that's very low. Gonna try 100. Yeah, the puddle melts much faster. So here you can see the dirty tungsten tip. This is a better looking tip. Let's try again. Dip, walk, dip, walk, dip, walk, dip, walk, dip. See, this is crazy here. But there is like a centimeter here that looks like a weld. Hey! Oh, I forgot to stay with it. You should stay with the argon in the end. Come on! I'm gonna test the strength of my first weld here. There's not a sign of movement on this piece. It's definitely strong enough for the marble machine. So once again, I'm not measuring the position of this. I'm using a physical spacer to bump it up against. So once I bump it up against this block, I can very confidently clamp this thing down, and I know that the distance between these two is
118 millimeters.
So after 2 days of preparation, I could finally make the first real TIG weld on the Marble Machine X. I was really, really nervous actually, because Marius' frame is such a masterpiece and I didn't want to mess it up, but I got them okay. And I only did the top weld, I didn't do the verticals, because I can tip the frame later when I need to disassemble the machine to put the real steel frame on the top, I mean. And it's much easier to let gravity help you when you're welding. So I'm gonna weld the other three sides of the square tubing once the machine can be tiltable. And this is the very first weld, and it's not the best in the world, but it really, really strong enough. So up until now, I have been quite restricted by not being able to weld, but now I feel that the assembly of the Marble Machine X can kick off for real, because welding is going to be a big part of getting this machine together. So now it all starts.
Edward programming registrator hands. Stop. These registrators are spaced exactly 21 millimeter apart. So first we have a 1 millimeter shimring, and then these bushings from Igus is exactly 20 millimeter. So when we slide it up to the next piece, they will be very precisely spaced apart from each other. This shaft is going to hold up the muting system, but also acts as a stop for the programming pins like this. And there will be felt here to reduce the sound. And here you can see how the springs work. And here is the spring tensioning system. And this is actually quite nice, because you can only pull out like this, change the tension of the spring, and let it go again. So now the spring is really loose. If I want to tighten this spring, I pull this out, I rotate it clockwise, and the spring is tighter. And the nuts are retained in this groove here. So I think this design is actually one of the simpler solutions imaginable. The threaded rod can't rotate by themselves because they're stuck here in the eye screw. We don't have the real springs yet, so this is just a test with some springs I had lying around. We've ordered these springs already, but they haven't arrived to me yet. Imagine when this is playing music like do do. There's gonna be so many cool angles to film where all these 38 channels line up like this, and you will see the melodies. So, let's go through the progress we made this week. It started with this pivot shaft in the back of the base of the Marble Machine X. And then we have this rod that the flywheel is going to attach on with a built-in belt tensioning system. That's the slot you can see there. And there's my first weld. It's really okay for being my fourth TIG weld ever, but I'm really looking forward to develop my TIG welding skills. I've been watching a lot of tutorials. This old Tony has a three-part series on it that is actually really, really nice. And here you can see the spring tension rod. And here you can see the muting shafts. To the left of this shaft that you see right here is a welded cap with a threaded M8 thread in. So this is how we can attach these shafts to the metal frame. There you can see the bolt. So yeah, there was a lot of work in getting the TIG machine to actually weld for me, thanks to the argon gas connection problems. And I haven't been able to practice so much, but I'm really looking forward to learn to do nice looking and really good TIG welds. This video got a little bit long, but I had 9 hours of material to edit down. So my task for next week's video will be to not overshoot with 900%. Okay, thanks so much for watching, and see you with more parts assembled on the Marble Machine X next Wednesday. Have a really nice evening, everyone. Bye.